When most people think of influential animated film directors, most people think of Walt Disney. But when I hear that question, I first of all think of Brad Bird because I love the Iron Giant. And I also think of Hayao Miyazaki, director of films such as Spirited Away and Howl's Moving Castle. Because while Walt Disney did bring animated films into the public eye, it was Hayao Miyazaki that truly combined animation and narrative to bring about a new form of storytelling. Born in the town of Akebono on January 5th, 1941, Hayao was the second of four sons to his father, Kazuji Miyazaki, and his mother, Dola Miyazaki. Kazuji was the director of Miyazaki Airplanes, the company that manufactured rudders for planes during World War II. At an early age, Hayao's family was constantly moved due to bombing during the war. From 1947 to 1955, Dola was diagnosed with spinal tuberculosis. She died at age 71 in July 1983. Miyazaki began school in 1947 at an elementary school in Utsunomiya and completed the first through third grades. After his family moved back to Sumiyaku, Miyazaki completed the fourth grade in Omiya Elementary and fifth grade at Ifuku Elementary. After graduating from Ifuku, he attended Omiya Junior High School. Hayao aspired to become a manga artist, but discovered he could not draw people, so for several years he only drew planes, tanks, and battleships. Miyazaki's interest in animation was sparked by the film Panda and the Magic Serpent. Hayao then attended Gasunji University and graduated in 1963 with degrees in political science and economics. Miyazaki was at first employed at Toei Animation and became chief secretary at Toei's labor union in 1964. Miyazaki would then go on to join many other companies such as A-Pro and Nippon Animation before eventually, along with Takahata, Takumi, and Suzuki, found the animation production company Studio Ghibli. Miyazaki can create such wonderful stories. From the characters to the worlds, everything comes together to make an incredible narrative. Miyazaki really put a lot of effort into the characters to make people that feel like, well, people. As an example, let's look at the protagonist of Spirited Away, Chihiro Ogino. At the very start of the film, she is self-centered, constantly complaining, and a bit of a brat. But she changes over the course of the story as her world is flipped on its head, as well as the fact that if she sits a centimeter out of line, she is literally going to the pig pen. As she dives deeper into the land of the spirits, she comes across friends and allies that in their own selfless acts teach her to be a better person. And as a perfect foil to Chihiro, we have the antagonist No Face, a mysterious spirit that was mostly used to rejection and loneliness for most of his life. And when Chihiro showed him kindness, he was never used to that kind of act. And in the end gets consumed by greed and hunger until Chihiro is able to get him to his senses. There are people who go through those problems all over the world, which makes them even more interesting and relatable. In an animated film, it takes not only good writing, but also good animation for the message to truly stick. And the animation in Studio Ghibli films is some of the best out there. From the walking, to the talking, to the fighting, every motion is carefully drawn to make the incredible animation we see on Ghibli films today. And who could forget the incredible music that plays, composed by a collaborator of Miyazaki, Joe Hisashi, and many other composers, giving us orchestral masterpieces that are a feast for our ears. And lastly, the backgrounds. Each landscapes are drawn from real world, making them look like art all on their own. All of these elements and more are what makes Hayao films incredible, and how he is able to capture wonder and adventure in each of his films is what makes him, in my opinion, the best storyteller of all time. Currently, as of now, Miyazaki is working on a film called How Do You Live? But there is no current release date. I believe the first Miyazaki film I ever saw was Ponyo. And from that moment on, I was hooked on Miyazaki's films, from Porco Rosso to Howl's Moving Castle. I enjoy every film he has made. I think he was the one that truly inspired me to become a storyteller myself, as well as an animator. I have some pretty good ideas in my head, and I'm really excited to create them in the future, and who knows, maybe it'll be a pretty big hit. And on the 0% chance that you see this, Hayao Miyazaki, let me just say that I love your stories, and that you are the one that truly inspired me to make my own.